Hey, Facebook. It is 12 o'clock. That means it's time for some Painting for Positivity today. And for those who are joining us for the first time, if you don't know what we're doing, this is basically a way for us to encourage social distancing while y'all are at home. And so we have a lot of us doing different things, and today we're going to be painting. And I figure since it's Earth Day, Earthlings, we'll paint little planet Earth there. So, getting started right now. Let me get my palette right here. Whoop. Okay. Okay. So, starting off, all my canvases have been black. So I pre-painted this black, and you could see the circle right here. I just used a little mug and then traced around it. So that's gonna be your earth. You can either leave it in the center or you can leave it on the side. So that's what I'm doing. Okay, so starting off, you're gonna create like a little nice blue space color back here. And so I'm starting off with the black and then different shades of blue. It doesn't really matter what brush you use, just as long as you're blending. But okay, so the paint is dry here, but I'm going to kind of wet the canvas a little bit and then we're gonna start blending. And then start mixing your colors whenever you start off. You have to make sure that the blue that you start with is somewhat dark. And it has to fade into the black. Okay, so that's kind of fading. And if you do a lot of, like, just kind of a tapping, then the color, the reflection, you might not be able to see it, but it'll start to blend. Also, just a heads up, if you are gonna paint an earth, you wanna make sure you're using different, not just like a bright blue. That seems to be the misconception a lot of people have when they're painting the earth, because it's not necessarily a bright, bright blue. Try not to put too much paint on your canvas. So make sure it fades into the black here. Whoop! I've been listening to some lo-fi lately, honestly. All that instrumental music, that spa music, has been making me fall asleep. And I'm just using a little bit on my brush. And when you're blending, you want to make sure that you brush it out. So this is acrylic. I'm always using acrylic, and it kind of looks like a glossy paint, but that's only because it looks like that because it's wet. But it usually will dry in a matte, so it's not going to be glossy unless you put a varnish on there. But they do have some acrylic paints that are, they do have a gloss in it. I'm just not using that. Okay, so I'm gonna lighten this part up just a slight bit. And with that, I'm gonna use this lighter blue. By the way, this type of paint from Artist Loft, it's going to come out very thick as opposed to some of the liquidy ones. So it's a little more, just a couple bucks more than the cheaper stuff, but not too bad. So you want to work fast because you want to make sure that you want to do this while the paint is still wet. Okay, and then I'm going to add some right here, some of that blue on the side. So you don't want to add too much of this blue. You want to make sure it's kind of like closer to the earth right here. I'm just using a little bit. You want to make sure some of that darker blue is towards the end, and then just kind of work your way towards the circle. And make sure there's no harsh lines. That's the one thing you want to try to avoid as well. Okay, now I'm going to add some of the lighter blue, just a little bit, towards the edge of the circle here, and then you're gonna start blending. And like I was saying earlier, just a lot of the tapping right here. Okay, I think I'm okay with that. I'm just gonna kind of add some more here. Picture them like clouds a little bit. I know there's no clouds in space, but like when you look at the Milky Way and it looks really pretty. Okay, now is the part where we start painting the Earth. So you're going to start out with a darker blue, and for this part I'm just going to use a smaller paintbrush just so I can see what I'm painting. Okay. And you don't want to actually have just like a solid blue, just one color. When you look at pictures of the Earth, it is, they do have different shades of blue for the ocean. So just take that into consideration when you are painting. Like maybe I'll dip into some of the lighter blue a little bit. Thank you. Hi, Debbie. How are you doing today? Okay, so on this part I am using two different shades of blue. And if you want to look at a map, just so you have a good idea on how you're going to map out your countries, it is good to kind of have a nice visual there. Good. I'm doing good today. This is kind of like the middle of the day for me. But we're almost through the week. Just almost there. Hey, Robert. How's your Wednesday? A lot of this you're going to cover up with clouds, so if you can't get it exactly, I know it's the Earth, so it's not like it has to be exactly the same. Good, I'm doing good. We're halfway through the week, y'all. Halfway there. Hey Marcy, thank you. How's your Wednesday? Now I'm gonna dip in to the black just a little bit because I do want a darker hue. And then just lightly tap. Have that painting, by the way. So it's still there. Thanks for always tuning in, by the way. I do miss Tate. She doesn't miss me. No, I'm just kidding. it's really crazy, y'all, how, I barely see anyone at News West 9. Just because the social distancing is real. I know it seems like we're still together, but a lot of us haven't seen each other in a long time. Like, seeing Nathan, as that was actually the first time in... how long? Like weeks since I've seen him. Hello. Okay, it's not perfect, but I am gonna go over it. So this part, it's mainly going to be black, but We'll shade that in after. Don't be afraid to go darker when you need to. Did y'all see some of that congestion in Odessa this morning? That was crazy. When we had Tate go out there this morning, I was like, dude, how many cars are out there? And she was like, because everyone was trying to get those free HEB gift cards. And she was like, I can't even explain how bad it is. I was like, dang. Okay, so now on this part, I'm going to add some shading on the bottom. I'm going to go over it though. Because it is the South Pole and it's not going to be completely blue. So on this part, I think I'm okay with that. A lot of this is going to be covered with clouds. So I think I'm going to add some of my stars. And I'm going to use a toothbrush for that. Okay. So I'm going to add, this is my painting brush. And I'm just going to, this is how I do it. I just add a little, like you're putting toothpaste, but not too much, just a little bit. And then I'm going to smear the top. You want to make sure you wash this because a lot of it just comes out very, it just dries up really hard and you don't want that. And you just flick. Then I'm gonna refill. So I think I'm okay with that. Okay, the next part is adding some of your countries. So you're gonna use green, and then you can use some brown, because of course not all countries are gonna be green. For this one, I'm gonna use some hints of yellow. Then I'm going to keep dipping the dark green in the black, so You want to give it some definition, because you don't want to make it completely green. I'm just gonna dip in a little bit of the yellow. Some of the tapping will help you blend a little bit. And this part I'm just going to go back over with the blue. And then I'm gonna go back, touch up on some of the oceans a little bit. Okay, remember a lot of this is going to be covered up in clouds. Okay. So now I'm going to use the same brush, make sure you wash it off. And then I'm going to use some white, and this is going to act as an outline around the earth. Make sure you're working with a dry brush. So you're going to add this white line on the side. And this is the North Pole, so I'm gonna put some white here. And then I'm gonna lightly blend it out. And don't forget, South Pole is gonna be white. Then I'm gonna add some light blue, just a little bit, like a little hint of it. And then I'm gonna add that on top of the white. And I'm gonna go kind of on the outside and then add this white outline. But just very lightly. And then for this part, I'm gonna also add a white line. And this is gonna kind of be the highlight right here. Okay, and now you're gonna tap. A lot of this is just gonna be tapping because you wanna add some clouds. What are we listening to? Now I'm gonna go through some of the black, and then I'm gonna add this black outline right here just to add some contrast. And then lightly, just lightly blend that into the earth. Okay, now I'm gonna go back in the white, and then you're gonna add a glow right here. So using the white, it's gonna be a line, so you're just gonna brush that across. And then you're just gonna add these points. And make sure they're straight lines. My brush is getting a little dry, but you get the point here. There you go. Little planet Earth. For Earth Day. So it is a little time consuming because you do kind of have to have an image reference, but I don't know, just kind of something to think about if you do decide to paint that. Tomorrow, I don't know what we're gonna do tomorrow, but hopefully it's gonna be something a little easier than that. So hope y'all enjoy and stay tuned. A lot of cool stuff coming up next week for sure, but okay. Everyone stay safe, and I will see y'all tomorrow at 12. Bye, guys.